I think there's definitely room for creativity. I mean, Absolut Vodka was built on creativity. Not that much patience, though. You know, we don't think that we're living in a time now where we can sit around for a long time and crafting the perfect strategy with an agency partner and then throwing it out there and hoping it's going to work. We got to move much faster than that. Otherwise, we're constantly going to be behind. So I think creativity, yes, but not that much patience. I'd rather try something out and fail than to try and sit and make something really perfect. Yes, definitely willing to fail. And we're accepting that most of the things we do are going to be failures. I think the important thing is you've got to be a learning organization. If you don't learn from failures, that's an issue. But failing in itself is no problem at all. If you're not willing to fail, you're not willing to try new things. You're not willing to bet on the future, and then somebody else will, and you're going to get caught behind. I think brands have to move at the speed of internet. You've got to be iterative all of the time. We talk about the fact that in our company, we're continuously in beta mode. We're always testing. We're looking at the world as our playground. We have to act that way. And once we do, we got to be accepting that a bunch of what we do is going to fail, but one or two things are going to work magically as well. I think the defensive posture is something of the past where, you know, you have a position in the market and then you're trying to protect that position. I think the aggressive posture is to say, all right, I may have this position and I'm going to do myself, you know, a favor by trying to do well in that position, but then I'm going to try these things as well. And one of them or two of them might work. And once they do, that's magic. Our eyes are on the future, very much so. I see a very bright future. If you take a brand like Absolut, I think the values that are intrinsic in the brand, creativity, we talk about creative activism, you know, we've always been on the side of LGBT and diversity. I think those are values which are going to be extremely powerful going forward. If we had a century or two now of bling and logos and excess, that's not really our kind of playground. I think the playground forward is a much deeper one, and it's a much more fundamental one. Insightful, and it's that kind of environment that Absolut really thrives in, so I have a lot of hope for the future. Well, first of all, innovation is not, you know, product innovation for us. You know, I think a lot of people confuse innovation with product innovation. I think anybody should be looking at what they're doing through the eyes of innovation, meaning, is there a smarter, a more exciting and a different way of doing something? And I think that's something that you have to ask yourself when you're getting into the office every day, and that's what we try to do.